A very good morning, one and all. And now we are discussing about the last topic of this chapter, that is the phosphorus cycle, which is an example of sedimentary cycle. So let's move. So what does mean by phosphorus cycle? Phosphorus cycle is an excellent example of sedimentary cycle. I hope you know what is meant by sedimentary cycle, right? Sedimentary cycle is nothing but here the reservoir pool of the concerned element will be what? A sediment or a lithosphere compound. Based upon the nature of reservoir pool, we have divided the biogeochemical cycles into two, right? A gaseous cycle and a sedimentary cycle. In the case of gaseous cycle, the reservoir pool will be atmospheric gases like carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, etc. While in the case of sedimentary cycle, the reservoir pool will be sediments. Okay, so the phosphorus is an excellent example of what? The sedimentary cycle. Then what is the need of phosphorus in our day-to-day life? We know that phosphorus is very much important for our growth as well as development. How? Have you heard about nucleic acids, DNA and RNA? The backbone of nucleic acid, that is composed of sugar and phosphate. So for this, we need for the backbone, for the element, for getting the element of the backbone of DNA or RNA, we need what? Phosphorus. So nucleic acids, the phosphorus is one of the component of nucleic acids. Then have you heard about ATP, GTP, CTD and NADP? These are what? Energy assimilatory powers, right? These are very much important for our all activities or metabolical activities. So in all these compounds you can see a phosphate here. So for the formation of most of the energy rich phosphates, we need what? Phosphorus. Okay, and apart from that, for the proper development of bones as well as teeth, we need phosphorus. So these are the main use of phosphorus in our life. Okay, for the formation of nucleic acids, for the formation of energy rich phosphates, and also for the proper functioning of bones and teeth, we need phosphorus. And hence we have divided the principal reservoir of phosphorus as phosphate rocks, fossilized bones of extinct animals and plants, and also the excreta of fish eating seabirds. So from these three main reservoirs we will get maximum amount of what? Phosphorus. Okay, so let's move to the detail of phosphorus cycle. Here you can see that this is the concept diagram of phosphorus cycle. Okay, as I told you that the phosphorus, the principal reservoir of phosphorus, phosphorus rocks. Then guano deposit means it is an excreta. The guano is actually a fish eating seabird. The deposit, the excreta of this fish eating seabird, like guano, and also the fossils of this bone deposit, fossil bone deposits of animals are also provides what? Terrestrial. They generally constitute the terrestrial reservoir of phosphorus. Okay, then first what happens is that the weathering of this phosphorus rocks or the decomposition of fossil deposits or guano deposits, what happens? The soil gets what? The phosphorus. Okay, by means of the weathering, by means of all these three processes, the soil will be provided with the much amount of phosphorus. Okay, then what happens? It enters to the soil. We know that plants are generally dwelling in soil. So what happens? The plants will absorb this phosphorus and it enters into the animals via food chain, right? The plants utilize this element for the various life activities, and the animals depends this plants for our food. So through food chain, this phosphorus enters into animals, right? Then what happens? By means of the excretion and also the decomposition of both animals as well as plants, they get will turn back into the soil. So from where this phosphorus is getting incorporated by means of the decomposition as well as excretion, it returns back into the soil itself. So this is actually only a part of the phosphorus which is present in soil. Another part of the phosphorus will move into a different way. A small portion of this phosphorus, what happens is that it will be sedimented in the shallow waters as shallow sediments. We know that by means of the running water, all the rivers, ponds as well as lakes are generally or finally merges into seawater. Like, right? So what happens is that by means of the running down of the water, the phosphorus which is present in the soil will move into the seawater and it will be deposited there as shallow marine sediments. Okay, and in the sea there are a lot of animals are living. So first of all, this fish will eat this phosphate sediments. Okay, so this phosphorus become the part of their body. Okay, then the frequently you can see that some birds are visiting to the ocean for feeding this fish, right? So when the birds feeds upon this fish, this phosphorus is moved from this fishes into the bird's body. Okay, so you can see that both in fish's body as well as the bird's body, you can see this phosphorus. Then how it enters into the terrestrial reservoirs? We harvest fish, right? And when we harvest fish, we will, after the flesh is consumed, we will remove their bones, right? So, or cartilage. So, their fossil or bone will be deposited in the terrestrial habitat. Also, when marine birds, after feeding, when enters into the seashore, they will deposit their excreta. It is mainly found on the seashore. So, in this two ways, the phosphorus which is circulated through this water is generally deposited in the terrestrial habitat. Okay, then apart from this, a very small portion of this shallow marine segment, marine sediment is incorporated into the birds and fishes. What about the rest? The rest of the shallow marine sediments will be deposited in the deep ocean sediments. Okay, so a portion will be deposited as deep ocean sediments. Okay, and this reaction is called a sedimentation. Okay, then have you heard about upwelling or geological upwelling? This is a process by which in those sediments which is present in the deep ocean will be moved into the terrestrial or the sea shore or sea coast. Okay, so actually this upwelling occurs only once in a million years ago or 60 million years ago. So whenever this upwelling happens, those sediments which is deposited in the deep oceans will be providing phosphorus in the terrestrial habitat or in the sea coast itself. Okay, so in this manner, the phosphorus is mainly circulated between terrestrial habitat and water habitat. So that's all about the phosphorus cycle. It's nothing but it is a very simple process. I hope you understood, and if you have any doubt, please make comments on the comment section. Thank you.